This is the last video for chapter 11, 11.7. We're going to do a word problem strategy of working backwards. You can still click on the description to see the 15 videos that we talked about polynomial functions. This one's not about polynomial functions, but it is going to help you. Sometimes a problem describes a sequence of actions involving numbers, and it gives us the result, then asks us for the number from which it started. And these types of problems can be solved by working backwards. Listing each step carefully is an important part of this strategy. So let's take a look at our first problem. A moving company put half of the boxes from a house into a large truck and one-third of the boxes into a smaller truck. 8 boxes were still in the garage of the house and 6 were in the attic, and these were to be moved the next day. So how many boxes were in each truck? Well, we can draw a picture to help us figure out what's going on. We've got half of them in the large one, one-third of them in the small one, 6 in the attic, 8 in the garage. Now, to solve this problem, we can start with the number of boxes that were still in the garage and the attic. We start by listing all the data from the problem. Half of the boxes in one, one-third of the boxes in another truck, 8 in the garage, 6 in the attic, and we'll work backwards. So we're going to start with this, and then we're going to work up, okay? So we're going to kind of make a U shape, really, to show the work. So the 8 plus the 6 equals 14 that are not yet loaded onto a truck. We also know that 1/2 plus 1/3 equals 5/6. That means 5/6 of all their boxes are already on trucks. Well, 14 are not. So there's 1/6 missing. That 14 must be the 1/6. That means 14 times 6 equals 84 total boxes. And if 1/3 of them are on the small truck, 84 times a third equals 28. And if half of them are on the large truck, 84 times a half is 42. We want to check our work. All we have to do is add the 42, 28, and 14 and see if it equals 84. And it does. So we know 42 boxes are on the large truck and 28 are on the small truck. All right? Now let's do one that's a little more confusing. Bob won $2 million playing the lottery and received the money on Monday morning. On Tuesday, he spent twice as much as he spent on Monday afternoon. On Wednesday, he spent 2/3 as much as on Tuesday. On Thursday, he spent $8,000 more than on Wednesday. On Friday, he spent 3/4 as much as he did on Thursday. And if Bob spent $21,000 on Friday, how much did he spend on Monday? Wow. So we're going to start with Friday and work our way back to get to Monday, okay? So here's our information. Tuesday was twice as much as Monday. Wednesday was 2/3 of Tuesday. Thursday was $8,000 more than Wednesday. And Friday was 3/4 of Thursday, which equals $21,000. So we need to find out what $21,000 is 3/4 of to find what Thursday is. So we can set our equation as $21,000 equals 3/4 x. We multiply both sides by the reciprocal of this 3/4 coefficient to solve for x. So we're going to multiply both sides by 4/3. It's the flipped around upside down version of 3/4, isn't it? When we multiply this side, we get 12/12. Well, that gives us 1x. And on this side, it gives us 84,000 divided by 3. When we do our division, we get 28,000. So we know Thursday is 28,000. Well, it also told us that Thursday was 8,000 more than Wednesday. So to find Wednesday, we just take that 8,000 away. We know Wednesday is 20,000. And it also told us that Wednesday was 2/3 of Tuesday. Well, if Wednesday's 20,000, 20,000 times 2/3 x, we multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of that 2/3 coefficient, we get 60,000 divided by 2. That means 30,000 is Tuesday. And if 30,000 is Tuesday, which was twice as much as Monday, we just divide that 30,000 by 2, and we know Monday was 15,000. Wow, he's really going through his lottery winnings. We could even take this one step further and figure out how much he spent total by adding all the amounts he spent on these days and subtracting it from the 2 million to see how much he's got left. So we could keep going, couldn't we? We could find a total spent, we could find total left. So working backwards sometimes is the best way to solve a problem, especially when it's very long and drawn out and difficult like this, and they're asking you about what happened in the beginning and they give you the information at the end. Okay? Like I said, this is the last video for chapter 11. Chapter 12 is all about exponential and logarithmic functions, and 12.1a is about inverse relations. And as I said before also, those 15 videos that we talked about polynomial functions are all going to be listed in this description, so you can just click on them, all right? And I'll add this to the Algebra 2 playlist so that you can get to it anytime you want to. And I'm counting on you to make it through this Algebra 2. I think you're going to be fine, and I'll see you next video. Bye.